We'll start with the next topic, that is limit of visibility. Limit of visibility gives you as how many satellites in an orbit a particular Earth station will be able to communicate. So suppose this is my Earth station on the surface of the Earth, and this is a, say, a geostationary orbit. So the limits of visibility of this Earth station will be from this particular point in the west to this particular point in the east. So let us derive first the expression when we assume that the Earth's antenna is actually having a 0 degree elevation, that it is aligned with the surface of the Earth. So the triangle that will be formed is ZO. I'll just mark some annotations to represent these points. Say satellite 1. And this is satellite 1 dash, S1 dash. So for the triangle OS1E, we need to find out this angle which will define the limits of visibility or the latitude from where the satellite will be visible to this particular Earth station. So we can directly, this we call it, and this is actually the maximum angle that we can actually have a communication with. So this is denoted as gamma max. So cos of gamma max, we can find it out as cos is nothing but the adjacent side, that is RE, divided by the hypotenuse, which is RS. So it is gamma max is cos inverse of RE by RS. So let's take an example of a geostationary satellite where the radius of the Earth is 6378 and that of the satellite in the orbit it is 42164. We find that gamma is 81.3. So the maximum that an Earth station can see is from 81.3 degrees west to 81.3 degrees west. But in actual case, we always have an elevation. Just at the surface of the Earth and just projecting upwards to see all the satellites in the space. But what happens is normally Earth is a radiating body. So it is radiating the heat, and if we keep it just above the Earth's surface, it absorbs a lot of heat energy, and these radiations add to the noise of the signal. And therefore, to avoid this practical difficulty, these antennas are kept at a certain angle. This certain angle it is kept to avoid your noise. And therefore, it helps to reduce the noise and the impact you can see. Instead of I being able to see all this whole region, now because of this elevation, what has happened is my coverage area is reduced from this particular 81.3 degrees east to 81.3 degrees west to a new value. Now our task is to find out this new. So now our task is, I have given you that the antenna is no more at the surface of the Earth, but it has got certain elevation. It has got certain elevation, and because of this elevation, my coverage area is reducing. Now tell me, how will I do this? So now our target is to find out this new value, that is gamma dash, which is the will give us the limits of visibility. For this, I am using the sign rule. I will use the text box. Yeah. Sign rule, which says I'm using it as gamma dash. So I'm representing it by R, small r, gamma dash. Is what? It is sine theta divided by the side opposite to it. That is SE will be equal to the angle sine of OES. angle OES, the opposite side will be what? RS, right? Whether you are at this point or this point, the orbit, it's a circular orbit. So here also it is RS and here also it is RS only, right? Yes or no? Correct? So it is RS. Okay, I'll prefer using a capital because to avoid confusion. Now the last is sine of ESO. ESO divided by what is the opposite side to it? It is RE. Right? Now tell me what you know and what you don't know. Can you tell me what is the angle or value of OES? This is OES. It is how much? Who can tell me? Priyanka, can you tell me the value of OES? How much is this?
90.
Yes. Plus there is some other 90. Value. Yes, I told you what is this?
Yes, ma'am. E plus 90.
Correct.
E
plus perfect. 90. Perfect. This is OES is OES is equivalent to 90 plus E. Perfect. So I know this value because E will be given to you. You will be told what is E and what is the side opposite to it is it is RS. What I want is I want this gamma. And if I, okay. Yes, so yes. What is our now next task is the formula that I had written. I need to actually be using that formula with the values that I know. So what we will do is simply put our value sine of gamma dash divided by, it is written as D. So I'm just representing it by D. Then sine of 90 plus E is equivalent to, divided by RS is equivalent to sine of 90 plus E. ESO divided by RE. Now I also want to know what will be the value of ESO. I know this is gamma. I know this is gamma. Yeah, this is gamma. I know this is 90 plus E. So what will be this angle ESO? ESO will be equivalent to the sum of the angles of a triangle will be what?
180,
right? So it will be 180 minus 180 gamma dash minus 90 minus E, correct? So it comes out to be ESO is equivalent to 90 minus gamma dash minus E. Okay. Sorry. Okay. So now what I'll expect from all of you is please substitute these values and give me the answer or value for gamma dash. Abhi aapko kya kya pata? You know RS, you know RE, you know E. So in terms of these known parameters, I want the value of gamma dash. So this is nothing but I can write it as it is equivalent to 90 minus gamma dash plus E. Correct? So this is nothing but again cos of gamma dash plus E. divided by Re, right? Okay. Now I want the value of gamma dash. Who can tell me what will be the value of gamma dash? अभी तो सब कुछ कर दिया मैंने रिदान, यू कैन गिव मी द आंसर.
यस मैम.
बताओ अभी गामा डैश पूरा एक्सप्रेशन लिख दिया, अभी मुझे बताओ गामा डैश क्या होगा. यस फातिमा, आर यू देयर?
यस मैम. यस मैम. हाँ
फातिमा, यू विल गेट टेल मी द वैल्यू ऑफ डी. आप डी का एक्सप्रेशन मुझे बताएंगे एंड रिद्धांत इज टेलिंग मी द वैल्यू ऑफ गामा डैश. Yes, Riddhant, how much time do you need? Where is Riddhant?
Sorry, ma'am, I'm not getting it.
Why? Ek simple expression nahi solve karna aata, trigonometry itna padha 12th mein. Yes, Kirti, can you give me the answer?
Hello?
Yeah, Kirti.
Ma'am, Ma'am, we'll calculate gamma in terms of only E or RS will do, right? Or both the sides?
E, RS and RE. Any value you can, all the three we can use. So I can just, you can see in this expression itself, cos or this.
So ma'am, it can be sine inverse of, just a second.
There'll be sine no sine.
Sine inverse of D cos gamma.
We don't know the value of D, Kirti. We don't know the value of E into E. What it will be? It will be RE will go up. It is RE by RS, right? Now taking the yes, cos inverse of both the sides.
RS. Ma'am, you have written E. Sorry. It will be RS.
Sorry. So what it is next, now I have to need the value of only gamma dash. So gamma dash will be taking the cos inverse of the other side. Cos inverse. This is, I'm trying to write cos inverse. Or cos inverse of cos of E into RE by RS. Correct? What else will be there? You have gamma plus E, right?
Minus
so
E.
Minus E, correct. It will be minus. Okay. See, minus E has just come down. I'm not able to correct it. Okay. Now this is your expression of gamma dash. So gamma dash will be defining your limits of visibility, and in this it will be this value, cos inverse of cos of E RE by RS minus E east to west. So the problems that you are asked is you need to actually directly use these formulas to get the value, and here we are assuming it is a geostationary orbit, so the latitude of the orbital plane is zero, and therefore I'll just do it fast for you. I derived the expression of cos of gamma dash as cos inverse of cos of E into R E by R S. Correct? Minus E. So I was just trying to tell you that you need to remember this formula for deriving the gamma value. And the actual limit of visibility will be gamma dash from the east to the gamma west, gamma dash in the west. Now, what is the coverage angle? Coverage angle is inverse or the reverse of limit of visibility. What was limit of visibility? It was nothing but you are at the Earth station and trying to actually see all the satellites in the orbit. Now, the coverage angle is, as I had already told, there is a coverage area on the surface of the Earth. So, it is nothing but related with the satellite, the inverse of it. That is, you are at the satellite and you want to see what all location on the surface of the Earth is visible. So, it is nothing but you need to find out this value alpha using the same relation. That is, and here we are assuming that the Earth is, again, the antenna at the Earth is at an elevation, some value. Normally, this value of elevation varies from 5 to 15 degrees to reduce the effect of the noise. So, can you tell me, abhi humne jaisa kiya, sign rule use karke, same thing. This is your RE, the radius of the Earth. D is the same, your RH is equivalent to R. S, the distance of the satellite from the surface of the Earth, and here again we are assuming the satellite is in the geostationary orbit. So I request all of you to take sign of alpha. For alpha I'm using small a divided by RE is equivalent to sine of 90 plus E. I'm using this +E. Divided by RS is equivalent to sine of beta divided by D. Okay, D is called as the slant range. Now we have, agar humne ek formula, if we derive, we can actually derive all the formulas using this relation. So what is our target? Our target is to get alpha. So alpha is nothing but A is equivalent to sine. What is sine of 90 plus E? We have already seen it is cos of E. Alpha is sine inverse of RE by RS cos of E. Can you tell me the value for this? RE is 6400 le lijiye and RS ko 42,000 le lijiye. The value of E to be 0 for initial and once you know E, you will be able to calculate the value of A. If you know A, E, you can calculate the value of B, that is beta.
Ma'am,
the value of RS.
RS is equivalent to how much? 42,000 kilometers. So what is alpha coming out to be? 8.7 degrees, right? The answer is in degrees. Okay. Now, what is the total coverage angle? The total coverage angle is nothing but this alpha is one side. Okay, but the satellite has the coverage angle on both the sides. So it is alpha on that side and alpha on this side also. So the total coverage angle when you are asked in the question is not alpha, but it is 2 alpha, that is equivalent to twice of 8.76, which is coming out to be, I think, 17.5 degrees. Correct? So the coverage angle is totally 17.5 degrees for the satellite. Okay? Now you need to calculate the value of D. If you know the value of alpha, you know the value of E. I'm taking it to be D minus alpha, that is 8.76, which comes out to be
32.
Our equation of cos of E by RS equal to sine of B by D. I can get the value of D. So give me the value of D. Yeah, correct. Your answer for B is 81.23. Okay, so approximately you are getting this answer. This is called as the slant range. What is the slant range? Slant range is your slant range. Now, why it is important to calculate the slant range? Because knowing what is the distance of a satellite from the center of the earth is okay. But when we are talking about the time taken by the signal to travel from one earth station to reach the other earth station, it has to actually travel from this earth station to the satellite and from the satellite back to this earth station. So the distance, but 2D, right? And the time taken, you know, is time taken is equivalent to distance traveled by the speed. What is the speed? The speed, it's an electromagnetic wave. So the speed is equivalent to the speed of the light. Can anyone tell me what will be the time taken for the signal to travel from one earth station to the other earth station? Simple. What is the speed of the light? It is 3 into 10 to power of 8 meters or 3 into 10 to power of 5 kilometers per second, right? Meters per second or? So accordingly, you will have to convert the units. Correct. 0.276 seconds. Now, do you remember when I was, remember this number that when you are communicating with the geostationary satellite, there is a delay and the delay is approximately 0.25 seconds that you will find in the books. So, this is from where you have actually proved that for a signal to travel from the Earth station to a geostationary satellite and back to the Earth station, there is a delay of 0.25 seconds, that is around 0.276 seconds. And depending upon your change in it, slant range and your propagation delay will change. Okay, so we'll take a break. I told you that one way of communication was one Earth station communicating with another Earth station with a satellite, that is called as point-to-point communication. Another way is when one Earth station communicating with the other station do not lie in the coverage area of a satellite, we need to actually communicate. There has to be a communication between two satellites and therefore calculating the total path that a signal has to travel and the delays, we need to actually calculate the distance between the two satellites, that we call it as inter-satellite. So this is a simple geometry example that you need to calculate. You know that. You know that this is your radius of the earth. It will form a perpendicular with the line joining, just touching your equatorial plane. This distance from the center of the earth to the satellite one is nothing but your 42,000 kilometers. And this is the satellite two for which you want to calculate the distance between satellite one and satellite two. Can you tell me using a simple geometry, at this point there is a 90 degree, this is 42,000, this is RE. Can you tell me the distance between S1 and S2? Chat box is enabled. You can answer, reply in the chat box. Simple Pythagoras theorem aapko use karne ka hai. Your hypotenuse is given, one side is given, you need to calculate the third side. If I name it as O, first you need to calculate S1O, and the distance between S1 and S2 is twice of S1O. I'm sorry, here I wrote it wrongly. The radius of the earth is correct. I got one answer. The radius of the earth is, I wrote it wrongly. It is 64,000 kilometers, 6400 kilometers. Yeah. I got one answer, S1, S2 distance. It's equal to twice of square of RS minus square of RE. So the answer is correct. 83,000 kilometers is the answer around. So those who could not find out, the answer is 83,000. So okay, you can find out how much will be the time taken for signal to travel. It was point for 41,000 around, it was 0.276. So it delay will increase as the distance between the satellites, the inter satellite distances, communication is taking place. Okay, so that's it from here. Now next is, I think, yeah, one more parameter. One more parameter that is important while defining or where the antenna from an earth station should look to, we call it as antenna look angles. So antenna look angles are like, where should an antenna be looking at? I cannot say this X, this Y and this Z. So when it is looking into the space, we define two parameters for defining where the antenna from an earth station should be looking so that it is actually able to see at the satellite and basically communicate with that satellite. So there are two parameters. One is an elevation. So this is your projection. This is your satellite. This is a sub-satellite point or the projection of the satellite on the earth. So this is your point on the vertical part to the satellite. So this line between the earth station and the sub-satellite projection, and from that, the angle into the space from this particular point looking directly to the satellite is called as angle of elevation. And the angle of azimuth is nothing but the angle moving from north to the projection of the satellite in the sub-satellite plane moving from east towards the west. Okay, so I'll just take four examples before we actually move, try to solve some problem. Is your Earth station can be lying in the northern hemisphere or southern hemisphere. And if it is in the northern hemisphere, again, there can be two cases. It is either in the east side or it is in the west side. So depending upon its position, we need to be actually calculating our azimuth. So elevation is simple. It is a sub-satellite. This is my satellite. This is the projection of the satellite on the Earth station, horizontal plane or the surface of the Earth. This is my Earth station. The line joining the Earth station and sub-satellite point, taking that as a horizontal plane, I just look upwards towards the satellite. That will simply give me the angle of elevation. And this azimuth, it is on the surface of the Earth from the geographical north to the projection or to the line joining the Earth station and the sub-satellite point moving in the eastward direction. So let's take the four examples. So I have drawn four curves and I'll be taking the four examples. This is my equator. I'm drawing the equator for all the four cases. Okay. Now what I will do is I will just have the, this is my north. Okay. So first is, this is my Earth station in the northern hemisphere. In the east direction. This is my Earth station. Okay. And this, sorry. This is my sub-satellite point. So this is the line joining my Earth station with the sub-satellite point. This angle, which we have between the Earth station and the sub-satellite point with the geographical north, is always termed as A dash. Okay? Now, what did I define the azimuth as? It is an angle measured from the geographical north in the eastward direction towards the line joining the Earth station and the sub-satellite point. So, how much is this angle? This is 180 plus A dash. So, for this case, your azimuth for this case is 180 plus A dash. Okay. Now let us come to a next case where my Earth, this is my north. Yes, Pratik, you have to say something.
Miss, can you repeat?
Yeah. अभी क्या है, मैंने क्या बताया आपको अभी, डेफिनेशन क्या था एजीम्यूथ का? एजीम्यूथ का डेफिनेशन था ऑन द लोकल प्लेन, राइट, ऑन द हॉरिजॉन्टल प्लेन. इट इज एन एंगल मेजर्ड फ्रॉम ज्योग्राफिकल नॉर्थ. दिस इज माय नॉर्थ, दिस इज ज्योग्राफिकल नॉर्थ. फ्रॉम द ज्योग्राफिकल नॉर्थ आई एम मेजरिंग, from the geographical north, I am measuring the angle to the line joining the Earth station and the sub-satellite point. So, yahan se yahan tak kitna angle hota hai aapka? 180 degrees, correct? But I have to move a further. What is this much angle? This is A dash. So, this is what is an azimuth, actual azimuth for a case when my Earth station is in the northern hemisphere and in the east, right? अभी ठीक है प्रतीक? Anyone has a doubt? कि ये मैंने कैसे 180 plus a dash डाला है? Now I'm talking about when your earth station is in the west. West माने आपका ये है आपका earth का latitude, earth station का latitude. This is my earth station. Right? This is my sub-satellite point, right? It is to the, when I'm saying east or west, it is with respect to the sub-satellite point. यहाँ पे क्या था? Sub-satellite point के east में था, यहाँ sub-satellite point के west में है. That is all. You need a reference. This is the line joining my sub-satellite. I told you the angle between geographical north and the line joining is always represented by a dash. Now, what is your azimuth? It is from the geographical north to the line joining your earth station and sub-satellite point moving in the eastward direction. How much is it? How much is this? Ye kitna hoga?
180 minus a dash.
Correct, correct. It is 180 minus a dash. Perfect. Right? Ye aapka total 180 hai aur aapka sirf yahi tak ho raha hai, toh it is 180 minus a dash. Now I have the example of, now it is in the southern hemisphere and again we have the point either towards the east or towards the west. So I'll be taking, marking geographical north kyunki wo to hamara reference hai, ye north hai hamara. And first is I take in the southern hemisphere, it is to the east. To the east माने ये है मेरा sub-satellite point और ये है मेरा earth station, right? And this is the line joining the earth station and the sub-satellite point. So the angle A dash is nothing but geographical north और sub-satellite point के बीच का, correct? Now it is there. Now tell me what will be your azimuth moving from the geographical north in the eastward direction to the line joining your earth station and the sub-satellite point. Now who will tell me what is your azimuth for this case? Kitna hoga?
360 minus.
Correct. It is yahan se ye pura kya ho jayega aapka? Ye pura aapka 360 हो जाएगा ये यहाँ पॉइंट तक ये पॉइंट से ये पूरा 360 सो इट इज 360 में से इट इज ए डैश इज रिमूव्ड नाउ कमिंग टू द लास्ट केस कमिंग टू द लास्ट केस वेयर
वन डाउट
या वन इज वेस्ट व्हेन माय अर्थ स्टेशन इन द सदर्न हेमिस्फीयर इज ऑन द west of the sub-satellite point. This is the line joining my earth station. Geographical north hai, toh ye kitna hoga? Ye a dash hoga. Correct? I say it is a dash. Do you agree with it? Yash, are you there? Yash Yadav? B, roll naam. Yes. Yash, are you there? Yeah, everyone, do you agree to this? What I have written, look angle. Look angle is nothing but, the definition of look angle is, it is nothing but the angle antenna alignments so that the antenna on the earth station, so that it is pointing towards the satellite. It is measured in two values. One is your elevation and the other is azimuth. Elevation is nothing but the vertical angle between the line joining the sub-satellite point and the earth station, and when you look vertically up, the angle that you form with the horizontal plane of the satellite plane is called as angle of elevation. on the horizontal plane, when you are measuring from the north in the eastward direction, from moving from the east, what do you see is, it is the angle between the geographical north and the line joining your earth station and the subsatellite, that is called as azimuth. Now, sometimes in the problem, basically the first thing that you need to identify is whether the point earth station is towards the east of a subsatellite point or to north. So I'm taking the first case as my earth station is on the east of the subsatellite point. And to measure my azimuth, I have to always move from my geographical north to the line joining the earth station and the subsatellite point. So what do I see is, when I'm moving from geographical north to this line, this is 180 degree, plus I'm moving ahead an angle of A dash. So azimuth comes out to be 180 plus A dash. Now coming to the second case is, when my earth station is to the west of my subsatellite point, again a line joining earth station and subsatellite point. Moving from the geographical north to the line joining earth station and subsatellite point, you know that from here to here, it is 180 degree. From here to here, it is 180 degree. And we are just measuring this much. This angle further is A dash. So the answer is 180 minus A dash. Now coming to the third case, when you are talking about the location of an earth station in the southern hemisphere, and it is east of the subsatellite point. This is the line joining earth station and subsatellite point. Moving from the north to the line joining the earth station and subsatellite point in the eastward direction, what do we find is, this whole yahan tak kya hoga, it will be 360, and we are stopping at this point. So this is 360 minus this particular angle, that is A dash. The last case is, you have the earth station to the west of the subsatellite point, and the line, this is the line joining earth station and subsatellite point. Again, I'm moving from the north in the eastward direction to the line joining earth station. Maine aapko kya bataya, geographical north or line joining earth station and subsatellite, there is always an angle called A dash. Ye fixed hota hai. Kyunki ye hum derive kar sakte hain. So this is fixed. So we always talk in terms of A dash. So when I'm moving from geographical north to the line joining earth station and subsatellite, what am I traversing? I'm traversing the same angle A dash, and therefore AZ is equal to A dash. Number one is application. So while starting with satellite, I told you that satellite has got various applications like for defense purpose, for your meteorological finding of resources, finding the water resources, weather forecasting. Some of the typical or new applications that have come are some of the applications because of the network that we are able to, satellite network or operation center, we are able to have the applications for military, defense, marine, direct to home, that television that you are getting, satellite phones, commercial aerospace, live coverage, the broadcast that you are receiving directly, the internet services, the mobile services, satellite phone. So all these are some of the applications which we actually, although we are not aware, but in everyday life we are actually dependent on satellite communication, and it is helping us in lot of things that are important for us. The first is, why this, I have written the question is, why banks are using satellite? Have you ever observed an ATM having a satellite antenna? Has anyone observed this? Yes? In the chat box? Nobody has observed. Next time when you go, you'll find that these ATMs have a receiving satellite point. Now what happens is, or why do we need this is, you know that whenever you are entering your card and when you enter your PIN number, what happens is it gives you all the information. Does it mean that every ATM has the information of all the users that particular bank will have? No. what happens is you have a centralized server system, right? So which has got the bank server system, which will have the information of all its users, and as soon as you enter your card, what you will see is once you enter your PIN number, it sends an information to the satellite. From the satellite, it connects you to the bank, and from the bank it retrieves the information and gives you back on your screen, and then you are able to, and as soon as you withdraw the money, it also updates back to the bank that this much money has been withdrawn. So there is a satellite communication at the hub, where it is the centralized operating system, or sorry, centralized office, which is actually receiving the information and giving back. Because maintaining that information at every ATM, because suppose I'm traveling, does it mean that when I go outside Mumbai, I'll not have access to an ATM? I definitely have. But how do that ATM know that I have that much amount to withdraw from my account? It is through the central system, and that is through the satellite. And these antennas, you can see, they are the small aperture terminals which are actually connecting you. The important thing about this is, since the amount of information that you are entering is very small, a 4-digit PIN number, the signal to noise ratio for this is very low, as well as from the central office to the satellite, the signal to noise ratio is very high, because for it, the number of users could be many at a particular time. But the requirement of this system is low signal to noise ratio. Is it clear to everyone that ATMs are using satellite communication? Next time when you go, see some ATMs have that centralized. Jo local rahenge, wahan pe shayad optical network se hota hoga. But sometimes when you go to the remote, वहाँ पे जाएंगे रिमोट बोल दू वेन यू गो टू सम बैंक्स विच आर नेशनलाइज्ड बैंक्स उनके पास ये सैटेलाइट टर्मिनल्स रहता है. सो दिस इज जस्ट सम थ्योरी विच आई हैड टोल्ड यू. सो इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू आर एबल टू रिट्रीव द इंफॉर्मेशन करेक्टली, एंड देयरफॉर यू नीड लॉट ऑफ सिक्योरिटी एज वेल एज ऑथेंटिकेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड टू एक्चुअली रिट्रीव द इंफॉर्मेशन, एंड ऑल दैट इज कैरिड आउट यूजिंग योर satellite communication. So dish antenna is placed on each ATM to connect it to various services provided by that particular bank. As the card details of a person has to be authenticated, information about his or her bank has to be fetched from the bank server, and then at last information has to be updated on the server after some transactions. So that is what I told you, that it is not only fetching the information but also updating. So it's a two-way communication. Don't think that it is only fetching the information from the server, but it is also giving back to the server the information about any transaction that has taken place. Now the second application everyone has now, that DTH service at their home. So what does a DTH do? Again, it is a kind of a hub. Basically, you have it's a one way, right? It's different from ATM that it is only receiving the signal. You have a broadcast service provider. The broadcast service provider, what it does, it receives the signal from the satellite, and from the satellite, maybe directly if it's a hub, it will directly send to your satellite, home, and you are able to receive. And every important thing about this I want to tell you is the services for broadcasting are actually given by ISRO. So a band is allocated. So Sony may be allocated a band, then Star Plus will be allocated a band. And according to our choice that we make, I want to have this particular service or this, you are able to fetch those bands, and that is being actually given to you as a customized service right now, because you are able to every service provider has got a different band, and as you select the services, you are actually selecting the bands, and only those bands are coming to your house. So it is direct broadcast, and already told you, I told you ISRO is the service provider. So even if you say I want to take some foreign channels also, but then it has to have a service provider in India, and that has to take the service through ISRO, that it will be provided to you. So 8 satellites are currently used by Indian DTH service providers. So these are some of the bands that are, all these satellites of DTH are in the geostationary orbits, and these satellites which are providing the services, like GSAT-15 is providing SunDirect, GSAT-10 is for Tata Sky. Every one has got that band for providing the DTH service. Now TV broadcast. So broadcast also, I told you that you will have a different houses producing the TV channels, and they will be sending it through the data network, and from the data network through to directly to the home that you are receiving these services. Again, these are dependent upon the bands that you are selecting for providing those services, and every service provider has to take it. Now, broadcasting will not only from a centralized office that it will be providing, like news channels, we know that they are mobile, and like this. They are mobile, so anywhere from their mobile, they can send it to the tower, and from tower, it will be sent to you, or from through the satellite, from anywhere else, if you are receiving, the direct broadcasting will take place at your home. Now, now next is your GPS. GPS, all of you know, it's your navigation system that is providing you the navigation. Actually giving you the path to the destination that you identify. So what it does, it has got multiple server stations which are connected and giving you the information. Presently, there are 24 satellites in this constellations. They are in the these are in the 6 orbits, right? So 6 orbit, approximately 4 satellites in per orbit, and 24 hour service that we are able to get using GPS system. So it has got a master control station, monitor storage station, and the ground station, and the space segment, which is communicating with you. So as soon as you give the information about what location you want, it simply processes through this control station, and the path is provided to you. There are certain devices which have already are fed with the paths, and they are helping you to identify the path to the destination from your present location. The last application is, it's what we have already seen, the VSAT. What is a VSAT? Is a very small aperture terminal. So the transmitting, the earth station could be having a big transmitting antenna, but the receiving or transmitting station could be a small aperture terminal that could be at your home where you are receiving the signal, or as we have seen from the direct broadcast, those are the antennas that are placed on the vehicles, and from there they are directly sending to their center, which is actually able to broadcast the news, the direct coverage. We all are now actually seeing all the direct coverages of directly from DRDO office, of CBI investigation. So they are directly standing there and broadcasting, and actually able to maintain the interest of the people as what is going on. Even the DTH uses for broadcast, means it can be used on not only for one-way communication, it can be for the two-way communication at ATMs. All these are using this small aperture terminal because of the size and the convenience that you have using it, and the high frequency that we are using help us to reduce the size of this. So this finishes our chapter number 1.